The story of the devotion to Our Lady of Candles. The natives had discovered the statue of Our Lady of the Candles in the year 1400, as it had been found in a cave, by two shepherds who had entered the cave, seeking refuge from a storm. Neither of them had ever seen a statue before, and so they thought, it was a living being. The sheep would not enter the cave, seemingly out of fear of the statue, so at first, the two shepherds motioned for the stranger to go away. When the statue did not move or respond, one of the men picked up a rock to throw at it. Instantly, his arms stiffened, so that he could not move, and his arms began to throb in pain. The other shepherd moved in close to the statue, and although it seemed to watch him, yet still, it neither moved nor spoke. Puzzled, he took out his knife and tried to cut its finger, but instead of marking the statue, his own finger received the wound he had attempted to inflict, and then he began to bleed profusely. Terrified, the two men fled the scene, leaving their sheep and everything else behind them. They reported what had happened to their chief, relating their belief that a great god lived in the cave. The chief commanded them to bring this being to him. Overcoming their fear, the two shepherds returned to the cave, and found the statue had not moved. When the first of them reached out to take hold of it, as soon as he had touched the statue, he found his finger was instantly healed of the wound he had received. The men reverently carried the statue to a house where their chief directed, and tried to show it honor in the best way they knew how. A few nights later, they were surprised to hear beautiful music, and to see strange beings, all glowing in the light, setting candles around the strange god and lighting them. The natives had never seen candles before. A special house was built for the statue, and for 50 years, there was beautiful music, light and a lovely fragrance surrounding the statue that no one could explain. The natives made offerings of fruit and flowers, and noted that the light beings kept the candles burning around the crude altar. In 1520, a native boy was captured and taken to Spain. He returned after a few years, and told the natives about Christianity. When missionaries came, the people were prepared to receive them and the true faith. Christians who had recently arrived and lived on a nearby island, recognized the statue. At first, they begged the natives to let them have it, but the pagan natives refused, claiming that it had brought them good fortune. The Christians decided to steal the statue of Our Lady of the Candles, feeling it was only proper that it should be in Christian hands. They succeeded in their plan, and brought the statue to their church, setting it on the high altar, and surrounding it with burning candles. Returning in the morning, they found that the statue had turned its back to the congregation, and no amount of pulling could get it turned to the front again. A serious sickness, then, invaded the island. Repentant and frightened, the Christians took the statue back to the pagan natives. Surprisingly, the natives had not noticed that it had been taken, because another statue, an exact duplicate of Our Lady of the Candles, had stood in its place, during the entire time the original had been away. Not surprisingly, the devotion to Our Lady of the Candles spread rapidly through Spanish countries, to South America and the Philippines.